फ्रेंड्स, आई वेलकम यू फॉर द पार्ट टू ऑफ आवर हिस्ट्री लेसन इवोल्यूशन ऑफ मैनकाइंड. इन प्रीवियस पार्ट वन वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द ह्यूमन स्पीसीज कॉल्ड एज होमो हैबिलिस. सो टुडे वील बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट अनदर स्पीसी ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग दैट इज होमो इरेक्टस. ओके, सो लेट्स बिगिन अबाउट होमो इरेक्टस. So you can see the picture over here. This is the picture of Homo erectus and the tools which were made from the stone, and these were made by Homo erectus. Okay, after looking this picture you will find that Homo habilis was looking different and Homo erectus was also looking different from each other. So what are the differences that we'll be discussing? Before that, we'll be discussing more about Homo erectus. So Homo erectus mark an important stage in human evolution. So here erectus means what? The meaning of the word erectus means the one who stands erect. The meaning of the word erectus is the one who stand erect. And if you look at Homo habilis, if you have remembered, so Homo habilis were not that much straight, they were not much erect, and their spinal cord was also little bit bending. But about Homo erectus, these could stand erect. Because of this they got this name. So he had developed a brain, was developed. Means if you compare Homo habilis and Homo erectus, the brain of Homo erectus was more developed, it was bigger. Why this was happening? Because the humans were using more and more the brain. So as the brain was being used more and more, the brain was developing, it was becoming bigger and bigger. So human of erectus species lived in group. So Homo erectus, they used to live in groups. Then having seen wildfire, human knew about fire. So these people, they have seen wildfires. So what is wildfires? Sometime what used to happen, suppose a lightning has fallen on a tree. So the tree will start burning. This is called as a wildfire. Or sometime the tree used to get fire naturally by coming closer to each other, and because of certain reasons, or overheat was also one reason, because of that the trees were getting burnt. Okay, so sometime they have observed this type of fire, they observe this fire and they like here picture, this picture you can see they are using the wildfire, and this wildfire, they didn't know much about how to start the fire, but they were using the natural fire that was getting from the burning from the trees. So they used to get this fire, and this was useful for some reason for these people. So the use of fire is one more characteristics of Homo erectus. And they have learned to fetching the fires, burning branches of the trees. At now only I have shown you. During this time most of the earth was covered with ice sheets. So that time the temperature of the earth was very cold. It was extremely cold, and the most part of the earth was covered by the snow, or it was covered by the ice sheets. It means the climate of the world was changing, and because of this there were certain changes that happened in his life also, So what changes happen is like, as earlier it was becoming warmer, but now it is getting cool and cool. So they need certain changes in their lifestyle. So what changes they had to do? The climate was extremely cold, and Homo erectus could survive in this extremely cold climate because he had learned to use fire. He come to know about how to use the fire, and they started getting warmth because of fire. However, he had not yet mastered the technique of making fire. So it means, though he was using the fire, but he was not able to start the fire. He was not using pebbles or stones to get the fire started. Okay, so this you have to remember. So, but they were using the fire for what purpose? As I was telling you, that time the climate was very cool, and these people could survive themselves because they were using fire. And the other reason was that they were using even leather clothing. So if the question is asked, how Homo erectus could survive themselves in the cold climate, cold changing climate, the answer is like, they started using the fire, and even they started wearing the leather clothes. Leather clothes were made from the animal skin. So tools which were made by the Homo erectus were more developed and symmetrical compared to those made by Homo habilis. So what is difference between tools made by the Homo erectus and Homo habilis? Was Homo erectus tools were more developed, they were more sharp, and symmetrical means what? Symmetrical as they required. Suppose we required a thing to cut the tree, so they used to make it as such a way that should be easy to carry, that should be easy to use. So symmetrical means we can say which was according to use, according to suppose how we can hold it, and is it comfortable to hold in the hands. So that care is taken, that is called symmetrical, as we required the shape. As per the requirement of the shape, they were making sharp tools as compared to Homo habilis. So this was the difference. Homo erectus made tools like the hand axe. So Homo erectus, these people made hand axe, which was kept in hand, and that was used. Remaining of Homo erectus have been found along with his tools. So his dead bodies or the skeletons are found along with the tools which were made by these people, and this was found in the continent of Africa, Asia and Europe. So these people's species and their skeleton, their evidences are found in Africa, Asia and Europe. So here is one construction of Homo erectus. He was also known as upright man. Okay, he was able to stand. Then brain was compared to Homo habilis, it was larger, it was more developed. Okay. And the food, if you look at the food of Homo erectus, it was same or almost same as Homo habilis. So food of Homo habilis and Homo erectus was almost same. Then Homo erectus, I told you about, they started using fire, and these people were living between 1.8 million years ago and 10,000 years ago. So this was the period between these two time Homo erectus were found, and they were living in the groups, and they were mostly hunter and gatherers. They used to hunt and gather the things, and these are the characteristics. So you can have the hand axe, and the spear is used by these people. So Homo habilis average height was 4 feet 3 inch, and Homo erectus height was 5 feet 10 inch. and long arms. Homo habilis had long arms, but Homo erectus had shorter and slender hands, arms, as compared to Homo habilis. So here is one reconstruction of Homo erectus. So you can see there are certain changes that had happened in his biology or in his body. So the skin and even the scale, skull and other body part are changing. So here is a reconstruction. You can see in the image the brain is getting developed. Okay, Homo habilis brain, and then Homo erectus, then Homo sapiens or Neanderthalensis, and Homo sapiens. So the brain is getting developed, the brain is changing, even their body structure is also changing. You can see in the image their standing position is also changing, the bending position is also changing, even face you can see there are changes in the face muscles that are so changing. So Homo erectus, some facts about Homo erectus. Evidences suggest that these were hominids, lived in small groups. They used to live in small groups, and it indicates that they may have used sort of language. They must have used a particular language, but they have not developed any words. And throats and mouths could complex sound in model language through. And these are the evidences, okay, that shows that these were intelligent as compared to that of Homo habilis. Now here is a video that is discussing about human evolution. So let's watch this video.
Millions of years before industry, agriculture, and civilization, the world stage was set for one creature's unprecedented rise. The story of humanity's evolution began about 7 million years ago, when the human lineage broke away from that of chimpanzees. Over time, an ensemble cast of over 20 early human species, or hominins, came to the fore. Most became extinct, while others might have been ancestors to today's humans. Each species exhibited varying degrees of human-like physical and behavioral traits, such as large brains, small teeth, bipedality, and tool use. These hominins fell into three major groups: early hominins, Australopithecines, and Homo genus. Humanity's earliest relatives lived between 7 and 4.4 million years ago in Africa. Having most recently shared a common ancestor with chimpanzees, they had many ape-like traits, such as a small cranial capacity. However, fossils show that some ancient hominins were also beginning to show human-like characteristics, such as small canines that were likely used more for eating and not for hunting or fighting. The next phase of hominin evolution involved primates called Australopithecines. They lived between 4.4 and 1.4 million years ago across the African continent. Like their ancient brethren, Australopithecines had some ape-like traits. However, changes in the skull, spine, and legs indicate a notable shift toward a very human-like trait, consistent bipedal locomotion. The third and current phase of human evolution involves members of the genus Homo. The earliest Homo species likely date to more than 2 million years ago, making them a contemporary of some Australopithecines. But unlike earlier hominins, who exhibited a mosaic of ape and human-like traits, Homo species were becoming distinctly more human. Their cranial capacity was growing larger than any other hominins. They developed sophisticated stone tool technology, and they became the first to control fire. These physical and behavioral adaptations, along with advancements in technology, allowed some Homo species to be the first to migrate out of Africa and explore the rest of the world. While a cast of over 20 hominin species have walked this earth, only one remains. Homo sapiens, shaped by millions of years of evolution, embarked on a journey of exploration and industry its ancestors could have only dreamed.
Okay, after watching this video, you must have come to know about how the human evolution has happened. And it has taken a lot year to make changes in the environment as well as the human characteristics. And the humans were getting evolved, they were getting change. They were getting change because the climate was getting change, the food habits were getting change, even their needs were getting change. As I told you, the time of Homo erectus, the climate was changing, so there was a need of protection from the cold atmosphere. To protect themselves from the cold atmosphere, they started some type of inventions, like they invented fire, or they started rather using fire instead of invention. So the brain was using, they were using their brain to develop themselves and make habituals that their life become more and more comfortable. And there was also use of fire for them to scare away the animals. As the fire was invented, they could scare away the wild animals. Suppose any wild animal attacks on them, so they used to keep the fire branch in the hands and used to scare the wild animals. Even there are some evidences that they started using fire to roast the meat. But this happened in the last stage of some of the human Homo erectus. So you have to compare with the each species of human beings. Like Homo habilis, how was Homo habilis looking, what was his food, how was his physical characteristics and all. Along with this, the new species which we are discussing. So you study it comparatively, like if you are studying Homo erectus, you study Homo habilis along with the Homo erectus. So if you are doing a comparative study, that will be useful for you. And you will understand better. So what changes are happening in the human body, what changes are happening in their diet and their food, that also you can know. So along with the new videos, you watch the previous video of the same lesson so that it will be easy for you to make a comparison. And I have given you already a task to complete in the part one, where I have told you to make a comparative chart on human species and how was their food, how was, which were the biological characteristics and the things I have told you in the previous part. Okay, so keep learning and take care.